Students, today we'll start our new topic, fundamental concept in organic reaction mechanism. So in this topic we will study about the electron displacement effect in covalent bonds, in which we will cover inductive effect, resonance effect. This chapter is very important for the fundamental concepts in organic reaction mechanism. Now let's analyze the electron displacement effects in covalent bonds. So electron displacement in an organic molecule can take place either in a ground state under the influence of an atom or the substituent group which is present itself in the organic molecule, or in presence of an appropriate attacking reagent. Okay, so based on this, whether it is taking place because of the atom of group present itself in the molecule or due to presence of an attacking reagent, the polarization, that is the shifting of electron, will be of two types. First is permanent polarization, that is due to the influence of an atom or the substituent group present itself in the molecule, and they are of two type, resonance effect and inductive effect. And second is temporary polarization, that is because of the approach of the attacking reagent. So the examples are electromeric effect or polarizability effect. So in permanent polarization, there will be shifting or displacement of electron in the organic molecule because of the atoms present itself in the molecule, whereas there may be temporary polarization, that is the shifting of electrons in the organic molecule when any reagent approach it to the substrate or the organic molecule. So electromeric effect is an example of temporary polarization, whereas resonance and inductive effect are example of permanent polarization. First, let's see what is an inductive effect. The process of electron displacement of the electrons along the chain of carbon atom due to presence of a polar covalent bond at one end of the carbon chain is known as inductive effect. This is a permanent effect, and we generally represent it as this: between this first carbon and chlorine. Chlorine is more electronegative, so it will pull the shared pair of electron towards it. So there will be a partial negative charge on chlorine and there will be partial positive charge on carbon atom attached to it. And because of this polarization, the electron cloud between this carbon, first and second carbon, okay, so this methyl group will have a tendency to shift the electron cloud towards this carbon. Okay, so electron will be displaced towards this carbon, towards the polar end of the chain, so as to minimize the charge produce or to stabilize the carbocation. Okay, so this process of electron shifting along the carbon chain is known as inductive effect. The reason is the presence of a polar bond at one end of the carbon chain. Okay, in inductive effect, the polarization of sigma bond takes place. It is caused because of the polarization of adjacent sigma bond. Carbon and carbon, they have the same electronegativity, so there is no possibility of polarization. But here polarization is taking place. Why? Because it is being induced by the polarization of the bond, sigma bond between carbon and chlorine molecule. Okay, so reason of the polarization is the difference of electronegativity. Chlorine is higher electronegative, so it will pull electrons toward its side, and because of this polarization, the polarization of the adjacent bond will also take place, and this process is known as inductive effect. And one particular thing about the inductive effect is, as we move away from the atom initially involved in the polar bond, okay, this effect keep on decreasing. That is, as we move away from the polar bond, the effect will keep on decreasing, and after three bonds or the fourth atom onwards, we can generally neglect the inductive effect. Based on the ability of the substituent to either withdraw or donate electron density to the attached carbon atom, the substituent can be classified as either electron withdrawing or electron donating group. Okay, so if the group or atom is withdrawing electron from the carbon atom or from any other atom attached to it, so it will be classified as electron withdrawing group. Okay, and if it is donating the electron towards the attached group, then it will be electron donating group. So generally we take hydrogen as benchmark because it is the least number of electrons on hydrogen. It has got only one, and electronegativity will depend on the number of electrons present on the atom. So similarly, we just classify the substituents into either electron withdrawing group or electron donating group. So examples of electron withdrawing groups will be those atoms which will have higher electronegativity, or those groups in which there is polar bond which will withdraw electron or induce the adjacent sigma bond to withdraw electron. Okay, so halogens are nitro group, cyano group, carboxy group, ester group, aryl roxy group. Basically it is just aryl is benzene like molecules. Okay, next is electron donating group. Electron donating group are basically the alkyl groups, methyl, ethyl, etc. Okay, next is resonance. So before explaining resonance, let's first analyze the benzene molecule. This is a benzene molecule. Okay, we represent it like this. Okay, it has got the formula C6H6. As we generally represent benzene like this structure, so this structure should exhibit two different bond lengths. One is CC single bond and another one is CC double bond. But experimentally it has been proven that all the carbon-carbon bond are equivalent, and the bond length is somewhat between the single carbon-carbon bond length and double carbon-carbon bond length. For example, the experimental value is 139 picometer in case of benzene. All the carbon-carbon bonds are equivalent, okay, and they have the bond distance of 139 picometer, whereas the single carbon-carbon bond length is 154 picometer and double carbon-carbon bond length is 134 picometer. So the single Lewis structure, which is represented like this, cannot explain this property, this ambiguity which is shown here. We expected two different bond lengths, whereas all the bond lengths are same. So single Lewis dot structure cannot explain all the properties of the molecule. What we do is, instead of a single Lewis structure, we propose different hypothetical Lewis structure to explain their properties. We have used the word hypothetical. That means that whatever the Lewis structure which we will propose will not represent the actual molecule. We are just proposing different hypothetical Lewis structures so as to explain their properties. These hypothetical Lewis structure will be called as resonance structure or canonical form or contributing structure, and this phenomena will be known as resonance. So finally, the real molecule, which we call it as resonance hybrid of all these contributing structure or the resonance structure. So let's analyze the benzene molecule. Okay, so we have shown these two canonical forms or the hypothetical Lewis structure. Okay, so there will be alternate single and double carbon-carbon bonds. Okay, So we could represent it by two different structures. Okay. So either it will have double bond in one structure and then it will have single bond in the other structure. And finally, when we overlap it, so we will get a resonance hybrid. So we'll just represent it like this. We'll draw a hexagon and then inside it a circle. So it represents that all the bond lengths are similar and they are somewhat in between single bond and double bond. So these are the canonical forms and this is the resonance hybrid. Apart from earlier two, three more structures are also proposed, okay, which satisfy the valency C6H6. Okay, so these two, they are known as Kekulé structure and these three are known as Dewar structure, but their contribution is very less in the final resonance hybrid. The Kekulé structures are more stable and they have more contribution in the final structure. So generally we ignore these Dewar structures, and in any chemical organic reaction we draw this structure so as to show the electronic movement. Okay, so finally you will get the resonance hybrid by mixing this resonance structure. There is another concept, that is resonance energy. So what is the resonance energy, or it is also known as resonance stabilization energy? It is the difference between the actual molecule which we get in nature or what you prepare in laboratory. So the difference between the energy of the actual structure and the lowest energy of the resonance structure. Like we get various resonating structure which we propose, so out of these the one having the lowest energy will take its energy and will take the energy of the actual molecule, will subtract these two, and whatever resultant we get will be known as the resonance energy. Next, take the example of nitromethane. Nitromethane, it could have two resonating structure. In one, it is CH3, nitrogen, double bond, oxygen. Then this oxygen is having a single bond and a negative charge. So this negative charge could shift over here. This double bond could shift to the oxygen atom and you will get another resonating structure. Okay. Similarly, the reverse could happen and then you will get the first form. So these two are the resonating structure and the real structure will be somewhat mixture of these two. So in experiment, you will not get two different nitrogen oxygen bonds. Instead, you will get the equivalent nitrogen oxygen bond, as we got a equivalent bond in case of benzene, not two different kinds of bond, that is single bond and double bond. Okay, so this phenomena is known as resonance, and these structure will be known as resonating structure, and the resultant structure will be called as resonance hybrid. We need to frame some rules so as we write the resonance structure. So while we are drawing the resonance structure, we should keep in mind that the position of the nucleus will be same and there should be same number of unpaired electrons. So let's take an example of nitrobenzene, negative charge on oxygen and positive charge on nitrogen. Then we will draw this alternate single and double bond. Okay, so first of all, you can shift this bond over here and this bond over here and this double bond over here, and you will get one resonating structure. We'll have a double bond over here, then this and then this, and similarly this bond could shift to here and this bond could shift to this direction. So we'll get another resonating structure. We'll have a positive charge over here. Similarly, this bond could shift over here. We'll get a positive charge over here. Okay, again, this bond could shift over here. We'll get a positive charge over here. This lone pair could shift. This bond could shift to this side. Okay, similarly, this lone pair could shift over here. This could shift to this side. Okay, so this way we can draw the resonance structure. Next is resonance effect. Okay. The bond polarity which is produced in the molecule because of the interaction of the two pi bonds or between a pi bond and a lone pair of electron present on the adjacent atom is known as resonance effect. Just recall the earlier inductive effect. Inductive effect was the polarity because of the polar nature of the sigma bond. And it was the polarity of the sigma bond itself. Here, this polarity is produced because of the interaction of the two pi bonds or between a pi bond and a lone pair of electron present on the adjacent atom. Okay, so in case of a benzene, it is the polarity because of the interaction of the two pi bonds. Whereas, if you have an atom attached to the carbon adjacent to pi bond which is having a lone pair, then also resonance effect would takes place. Okay, it has got a lone pair, so it could shift over here and this would shift over this side. Okay, so the polarity could take place either because of interaction of two pi bonds or because of a pi bond and a lone pair of electron on the adjacent carbon atom here. So based on this electronic shift, like in case of the inductive effect, there was two effect, plus I effect or minus I effect. Similarly, we'll have two resonance effect, plus R effect and minus R effect. So that is plus R effect, that is positive resonance effect, when the transfer of electron is away from the atom or the substituent group attached to the conjugated system, then it is plus R effect. Okay, we are taking the example of aniline. Nitrogen has got a lone pair. Now it is donating its lone pair and the shift or the transfer of electron is away from the substituent group or atom towards the conjugated system. That is, in case the conjugated system is benzene, whereas the substituent group is NH2 with nitrogen having the lone pair. So this lone pair will shift to this position. This bond will shift over here. Okay, so positive charge on nitrogen, negative on this carbon. Then again, the shifting will take place and these are all the resonating structure. Finally, we can see that there is a positive charge on the substituent group or atom. In this case, it is nitrogen and there is a negative charge on the conjugated system. It is our benzene ring. So in plus R effect, there should be atoms having at least one lone pair which is in conjugation with the conjugated system. Okay, conjugated system means alternate pi and sigma bonds. That is, there will be a pi bond, then a sigma bond, then pi bond. Okay, so these are conjugated system, means alternate pi and single bond and double bond. Okay, similarly, there will be negative resonance effect, that is opposite to it. Now the transfer or the shift of electron will be towards the atom or the substituent group from the conjugated system, as in case of nitrobenzene. Okay, so now this pi bond is shifting towards nitrogen. This will shift over here. Then these will shift, this will shift, this will shift. So we'll get the net positive charge on the ring and there is negative charge on the nitro group. So the electron density is shifting away from the benzene ring towards the nitrogen group. So the nitro group will show minus R effect or negative resonance effect and it will reduce the electron density of the ring. So minus R effect will reduce the electron density in the ring and plus R effect will increase the electron density in the benzene ring. Okay, thank you.